Tayshaun Chisholm. Offensive lineman from New Brunswick, New Jersey. And finally, Fred Quigley, wide receiver from Washington, D.C.
I've been here once, they're on both sides. So I don't know, I mean, they were, like the OC was right there and the D.C. was right there. Yeah, you're good there.
Thank you. And good afternoon, everybody. We're coming to you live here from Dickerson Stadium in Lake and Ray Field here at West Virginia State University, home of the Yellow Jackets, as we have Yellow Jacket football today on Senior Day, as they will be taking on the Golden Eagles of the University of Charleston. And both teams looking to, in their own respects, to make some good things happen. Of course, West Virginia State today, who will be without their quarterback, Donovan Riddick, who went down with an injury last week against Wheeling and will not be playing today. In his place will be number 19, Caleb Jantois, who will be making the start tonight. And for the University of Charleston, they come into this game with an 8-1 record, their lone loss being to Fairmont State. If they win today, then, and here, because this is some big things on the line for them. If they win today, they win the conference outright. If they lose and Fairmont State wins, then they will split the MEC conference. So definitely a big rivalry game coming in today. These two schools going at it here on Senior Day, and a lot of good things that can be said about both schools and their athletes as we're in the coin toss, which looks like Charleston won, and they will defer to the second half. So West Virginia State will start out with the football, and it's going to be interesting to see what the Yellow Jackets do, how they come out in this one, to just given the absence of Riddick. And Jantois, of course, will be looking to prove himself and looking to show what he's capable of. He has a good core of receivers, and I'm sure this week they spent time working on their timing and getting everything down on that end. And then for Charleston, you have an offense that is poised and brings a lot of great things to the table. You have quarterback Javonte Howard, who has come in and been a mature leader that has helped their offense essentially reach 43 points a game this year, and one of the best offenses in the country. And of course, you also have in the backfield, it's nice to have a player like Chavon Wright, the 5'9 sophomore, who has had his second straight 1,000-yard season. He's had at 1,132 yards this year. He has ran for 30 touchdowns in his career. And, of course, for State, you have Joel Felder, who has been one of the premier backs in the country. Look, only 50 yards away. In fact, if he reaches 50 yards rushing tonight, Felder will be the first West Virginia State running back to have hit 1,000 yards since 1988. So we have a great atmosphere today, a lot of energy from both sides, and there's going to be a lot of good things going on campus today as well. We've got football, but we also have, of course, later on today, we'll have basketball as a team who won last night, the Yellow Jackets. They've defeated Winston-Salem State. They will take on Shaw University today. So we have a full day of action here at West Virginia State as the teams are flipping sides, and that will be watch for number 14, Jawan Bunch, who will be returning the kickoff, and we will get things. That's him, and then number back and caught. That's Monroe. He's going to break through a tackler and juke the defender and get to close to the 30-yard line. That's the 30. That was Levi Paxton, the freshman, who kicked for Charleston. And here comes the offense. So now you have, first off starting tonight, we have at left tackle, we have number 77, Tayshon Chisholm. We have, who's a senior, we have number 62. We have Justin McKenzie out there, number 62. And then number 70, David Dawson at center as the ball's handed off. And that's going to be Felder who carries it for a few yards. And then at right guard, we have number 78, Brody Sipple. And at right tackle, number 50, Andre Sagastumi, who's out there. So that's going to be a gain of 4 for Felder. And now second and 6 coming up as man in motion. It's going to be pitched to Felder, left side. He's looking for room. He's going to take it, cut it up, and get about another 4. So now that's going to be about 5, so that's going to make it 3rd and 1. And I say we're probably going to see a big dose of Felder. We're going to see him early and often. As that's Jantois in the backfield with him, and the third and one. Man comes in motion, and it's going to be a quick pass thrown and caught, and that's going to be a first down. Cuts up the middle, past midfield, and that's going to be put the Yellow Jackets into Golden Eagle territory. That catch made by number 11, Amari Airy, the freshman, and they're continuing that fast-paced offense right back on the line as it's going to be first and 10 for the Yellow Jackets, starting from the UC 45. Of course, last year, a barn burner of a game, 42-35, in which West Virginia State was able to pull out the win when these two schools played. Felder gets plugged up the middle. The defense right there on the stop. It looks like number one, Miller, the sophomore. All right, and number four, Willie Floyd, who was on that for Charleston. So second and 9 now coming up for the Yellow Jackets. Three-man front for the Golden Eagles. It's going to be snapped. Jantois is going to roll out. Quick out, and it's incomplete. And that was intended for number 12, Nolan Johnson. So it's going to be third and 9 now. And depending on the marker, I mean, you could be in fourth down territory. And I say will be unless it's a longer yardage situation, just given this type of game, just the rivalry, everything that's on the line here. And they'll call at the line. Jantois blitz showing. As that's Floyd creeping up to the line on the third and 9. They need to get past the Charleston 35 to get the first down. And it's snapped. Jantois under some pressure, going to drop back. He's going to heave it downfield. He has a man caught by Jawan Bunch. And that is going to put West Virginia State in the red zone. Or no, they're going to call it incomplete. I apologize. He must have been out of bounds, so that's going to make it fourth down. That Bunch just couldn't quite get him in stride, so that's going to make it fourth and 9 coming up, and the punting unit will come out as Schmidt on the field for the Yellow Jackets. And that's Marrero back to receive and the ball's up. It's going to go, and it's going to take a state bounce, and Charleston will start with the football on the 5-yard line. Of course, again, we know we will see Charleston gunning. This is a team that is looking to get an outright conference championship today. A win will give them that. And so now offense getting ready to come out, and of course I suspect we will see a heavy dose of, as I mentioned earlier, a heavy dose of sophomore Chavon Wright. And we want to take this opportunity first off in between as we celebrate Veterans Day weekend, to thank those that have fought for our country and just what they've done. And definitely just an honor. The veterans are the reason that they're the reason we're here. The people that have put sacrificed and done so much for our country and for events like this to go on. I mean, you think of so many things that we as a nation are able to do. I mean, we're able to vote on our leaders. We're able to go and, I mean, enjoy and pick the career that we want to be. There's so many things to appreciate, and our veterans are definitely, of course, my father who fought in Vietnam, and I know many others out there, many others who have contributed, and much appreciation to you. And the school took time to honor veterans prior to the game, as it's going to be shotgun formation for the Golden Eagles coming out, and it's going to be handed off. They're going to go up the middle, and the state line right there to plug it up. And that was right on the carry, so that'll be his first carry. It looked like Jeter was in on that stop. So now that's going to make it 2nd and 9, and it's going to be run up the middle again, and with a train of steam, and that's what I'm talking about. It's these backs for Charleston there, as that was number 5 Wright again, but they do such a good job, and that's a sign of just a great, greatly coached team. I mean, they keep their feet moving, they drive, just things that are done, just little disciplined things as they need to get past the 16 to get to the first down on this 3rd and 3, and it's going to be Wright again, but this time he's met in the backfield. So West Virginia State able to get back there. That was number 44, Cam Vargas, the junior, that got back there, and the punting unit will come on for Charleston. So 3 rushing plays called early as that's going to be 4th and about 1. And they're going to send on, looks like Hayden Pack coming out there, the sophomore. And it's going to be West Virginia State, they're coming at it to block, and Bunch is going to call a fair catch. So the Yellow Jackets will take over 1st and 10 on the 37-yard line. And, of course, West Virginia State, they are coached by John Pennington, and much improvement that they made over the time that he's been there. Coach Pennington in his 7th year. And, I mean, this is one of the rare times that they'll either have a – They'll either finish at 500 or have a losing season, but with Coach Pennington, the Yellow Jackets have been tremendously successful. They've been able to challenge. I mean, you picked up a win last year against the University of Charleston, and that says just so much about just how far this program has come to compared to before. And when you look at the history, I mean, they've never had. More, I don't think. I think there's only been a couple times they've had 8 wins in a season. But the program under Pennington has become better and better to where football now is something that is highly, highly regarded on campus. People are excited about the football team. They want to come out and watch the sport, and they want to see this program continue to develop and succeed. So, and no doubt about it, what a time to prove it today against a team that's been an excellent representative in the MEC and the University of Charleston, as now State coming back out. Trying to get that off, big offensive line coming out there, as that's going to be 1st and 10 coming up. Big Nate Baker, the tight end, in the backfield. As guys creep up for Charleston, that's going to be Felder. He has room. Felder 50, close to the 40. Felder finds a nice seam and is able to get close to 20 yards on that play. That'll be a gain of 21 yards. So first down, as that's going to put him again in Golden Eagle territory, as they're going to go for the deep ball to Airy. Caught! And, just dropped out of bounds. That's the second time Airy had it, and it just flew out of his hands. The freshman got open. Airy, who had an amazing one-handed reception on a play like that against West Virginia State, or against Glenville State in a win earlier this season. So now that's going to make it 2nd and 10 coming up for the Yellow Jackets. But Jantwal showing early. I mean, he's had a couple good place balls like on that one, and showing some good play from the quarterback position. So 2nd and 10 now coming up, and it's snapped. Jantwal, he's going to hand it off. Felder jukes, goes up the middle, and he's going to fight his way for about 3 more. Felder right now, that was his 5th carry. And Jantwal right now, 1 for 4 for 17 yards on the game, as now it's going to be 3rd and 8 coming up for West Virginia State. They need to get past the Charleston 32 to get the first down. So Bunch in the slot at the bottom of your screen. And it snapped. Jantwal under pressure. He's going to throw it to Felder. A short throw and a flag down. We'll see what the flag is. It falls, I'd say, in the vicinity of holding, but that is going to be a loss. And that's going to be roughing the passer against Charleston. So that will bail out the Yellow Jackets. That's something Jantwal, of course, Jantwal, a young quarterback, and he'll learn more about just getting that ball out quick on those short plays like that. But he took a hit afterward, and that's going to give the Yellow Jackets a first down on the 28-yard line of Charleston here in the first quarter. As this game is flying. These two teams, just the pace they're playing right now, it's been electric as now that's him in the backfield. And then, of course, watch Bunch at the bottom of your screen slot there. It's going to be handed off Felder right side, and he's brought down. And it looked like that was number 8, Dyson Yulee, the junior, who made the tackle. So that'll be a gain of about 2 or 3. So 2nd and 7 coming up now. As the Yellow Jackets snap it, Jantwal quick throw and incomplete. So I think he was expecting a different route from Amari Airy. So now 3rd down coming up. It's going to be 3rd and 7 for the Yellow Jackets. And they will need to get to the 18-yard line of the Golden Eagles to get the first down. Right now, West Virginia State is 1 of 2 on 3rd down conversions. And Jones goes into the backfield, and it's snapped and faked to Felder. He's going to go for the deep ball to Airy and overthrown. So that's going to make it 4th down on the 25. A flag on the play, however. We'll see what that flag is. Officials are discussing. And they're going to call holding against the defense. We'll look at that. I'm not sure about that one from what I saw. But that's going to give the Yellow Jackets a first down on the 15-yard line of Charleston. So a 2nd straight penalty bails out the Yellow Jackets as fakes in motion, and Jantwal's going to run it left side, and he's drugged down in the backfield. And that was a nice disciplined play in the backfield by number 33, Andrew Chambly, the 6'1", 215-pound sophomore, making it 2nd and 15 now for the Yellow Jackets here in the red zone. And Jantwal's going to roll out, and he's going to lob it to Airy. Caught, kept it, looked like he was in there, going to call it a catch. So Jantwal trying to go to Airy quite a bit early, as that's going to make it now 3rd and about 3 coming up for the Yellow Jackets here with 8 minutes to go in the first quarter. So right now 25 yards through the air, 32 on the ground for the Yellow Jackets as they need to get past about the 6-yard line of Charleston to get the first down, as it's going to be a pitch up the middle to Baker. He's going to power his way in, and the big guy gets into the end zone for the touchdown. Big Nate Baker with the touchdown for West Virginia State, and that was a nice play design. They tried to flip it out. They, of course, Felder commands so much attention. Instead, they give it to Baker. And West Virginia State on the board first here. And as Schmidt will come out for the extra point attempt, it's up and good. So here with 7:39 remaining in the first, West Virginia State ahead 7-0. We're going to be right back. You're watching Yellow Jacket Football on the MEC Network, brought to you by Video Productions.
Life things aren't scripted.
If you're an athlete, we need people like you and translate those skills to officiating.
You can get a lot out of it.
It happens in every town, in every game.
We never have a perfect game, but the rewards always outweigh the negativities.
Back. That's only Baker's fourth reception of the season, his third touchdown, as it's a short kick and Charleston looking to make something out of it, and they're going to get pretty good field position. They'll start from the 35. Of course, the University of Charleston, coached by Quinn Sanders in his second season as a head coach, the fourth head football coach of the University of Charleston since they resumed operations and as a football team in 2003. And, of course, Charleston, who's been an excellent representative in many ways in the MEC and on a nationwide scale, as now they're coming out on offense, as the last time it was three running plays and they punted on fourth and one. We'll see what they do here. As, of course, they're in much better daylight than they were before. It's handed off, and they're going to give it up the middle. Looks like Wright again, and he's going to gain about – three. That'll be second and six coming up. I think that was Tillman that got the stop for the Yellow Jackets, and it's a fake this time, thrown outside, bobbled a little bit in the backfield, and that is number nine, Corlin Witcher, the senior, on senior day that gets back to make the stop. And a flag down. And that was a late one. I'm going to lean it's in the realm of unsportsmanlike late hit. But we will see. And that's going to be unsportsmanlike conduct going against number five, Justin David of West Virginia State. And that is going to move the ball 15 yards. So just when Charleston bails out the Yellow Jackets on the prior drive, the Yellow Jackets with a bailout on what would have made a third and long situation for the Golden Eagles. As now it's first and 10, and the Golden Eagles now have the ball in West Virginia State territory here. And it's sent, and man in motion, and he's sacked! And that is number 36, Jalen Jones. One of the seniors honored today as he got back there, and that's going to be second and about 18. You can see he just got back there and just blew off the ball to make the hit, so that's going to be second and about 20. Coming up now for Charleston. And it's going to be a quick throw to the flat screen. It's caught, and that's going to be a gain of close to 10. And the pass was complete to Marrero. Brought down by Scott. Avery Scott, the sophomore. So third and 10, they need to get past the 37. Of the Yellow Jackets to get the first down. They're going to go for the deep ball. It's caught, and he's going to go into the end zone. What a play by the University of Charleston on that. And that was Marquan Heron, the 6 foot, 170 pound sophomore. Look at the concentration. On the and I don't want to just credit Heron on that. I also want to credit that offensive line. They picked up the blitz nicely and was able to provide protection for Howard to complete that pass. But now Charleston gets into the end zone and has a chance to tie it up here as we get later in the first quarter. As that's Tim McCutcheon out to kick, and it is good. So we're knotted up at 7 here in the first quarter. We're going to take a break. You're watching the MEC Network, brought to you by Video Productions.
In NCAA Division II, community engagement is an initiative at all 25 national championships because student-athletes want to give back while competing for a national title. Over the course of the year, Division II student-athletes have an opportunity to leave a lasting impression in local communities throughout the country. Whether Division II student-athletes are volunteering at hospitals, schools, after-school care programs, foster homes, or retirement villages, they make a difference in the lives of others. In Division II, we rise to the opportunity and make community engagement ours.
Choosing health coverage for your family, your employees, and your company is one of the most important decisions you can make. The health plan proudly supports our active and healthy communities and has been your most trusted carrier for over 40 years. We are here for your family. We are here for your business. We'll be here for you when you need us most, because your health coverage is our priority. The health plan, here for you.
And we're back. Paxton out to kick off for UC. And it's up in the air. They're going to go back, and Monroe's going to catch it. He gets up 20 and tries to break through the tackler, but gets brought down close to the 25. So now State will... Or when that was Ashton Gilkey that made the stop for UC, the senior from Westerville, Ohio. And now that's going to make it 1st and 10 coming up as the Yellow Jackets, who scored on their last drive, and Jantois going to throw it first play. It's caught by Johnson, and he's going to get close to a first down. So Jantois 5 for 9 right now through the air, and Johnson able to get the first down for the Yellow Jackets on his first reception. And that was Heron on the tackle, as now it's going to be a fresh set of downs. As that's going to be handed off up the middle and met right in the backfield. That was number 27, Pessoa, the sophomore, who carried it. That'll be a loss of about 1 on the play. So 2nd and 11 coming up. Pessoa, who's proven to be quite a capable running backup, too. So now they need... The Jackets need to get past their own 45 to get the first half. That's Akayenzu on the tackle as it's faked, and Jantois pressured, thrown and caught, and that's going to be a gain of about 7 on the play, or closer. No, that's going to be a first down. Apologies, a bad angle, but that was pass was complete to the sophomore, Tayshawn Butler. So Butler with it. Butler, Felder, and Baker all with catches from the backfield for the Yellow Jackets, and it's going to be a fresh set of downs. 2 first downs on this drive, both through the air. It's going to be handed off again as Pessoa is going to take it for about 3. So about 4, so it'll be 2nd and 6 coming up for the Yellow Jackets. And that's going to be Pessoa, Baker, and Jantois in the backfield. And it's snapped. It's going to be handed off. Pessoa looking for a seam up the middle, and he's not going to get one. The ball came out, and Charleston indicating they have it. And they're going to say his knee was down. So that'll make it 3rd and 6. Third and five on forward progress, so West Virginia State will need to get past the 45 of Charleston to get the first down. That was Miller, Aiden Miller, who got in there on him, and Willie Floyd, who got in there on that tackle. And it's faked. And Jantois throws it. Caught by Johnson. First down, and he's going to get to the 37-yard line of the Golden Eagles. So three first down passes on this drive for the Yellow Jackets.
That's a Yellow Jacket first down.
So State right back on the ball. And it's snapped. Jantois, it's handed off up the middle. Felder's going to carry it and get met right there. Gosh, that's a big, strong line to run on. That was big number 94, Nick Evans, the defensive end for the Golden Eagles, the junior from Boston, Massachusetts, on the tackle for loss, and that's going to make it second and 12. And Juwan Bunch goes in motion. It's snapped. They're going to give it to Felder up the middle. He's going to carry the ball with a couple defenders as well and get about 5-6.
Felder on the carry.
So that's going to make it third and six now here as we're under 2 minutes to go in the first quarter. So probably two down territory for State as they need to get past the 28 of Charleston to get the first down. West Virginia State right now three of four on third down conversions, although they've had a couple, a little bit of help from penalties on a couple times on third down today. As that's Jantois and Felder in the backfield, and we have a timeout, the first timeout taken by West Virginia State. We're going to take it with them. We're knotted at 7. You're watching Yellow Jacket Football on the MEC Network, brought to you by Video Productions.
Life, things aren't scripted.
If you're an athlete, we need people like you and translate those skills to officiating.
You can get a lot out of it.
It happens in every town, in every game.
We never have a perfect game, but the rewards always outweigh the negativities.
Back, we have a third and six coming up for the Yellow Jackets, who just used their first time out of the half. They need to get past the 28 of Charleston to get the first down.
Third down and six for the Yellow Jackets.
And it's back, blitz coming from Charleston. Jantois rolling out. He's going to go downfield to Airy, and it's picked off. That looked like, we'll take a look at that again. That looked like Gilkey that got a piece of that. That was good coverage, good pressure, and that is going to result in the turnover. So Jantois throws his first interception of the day. So Ashton Gilkey having a nice game. Good couple tackles out there. And now that's going to set up the Golden Eagles deep in their own territory once again. But, hey, they have the football, as that's going to be Howard and Wright in the backfield. And it snapped. It's a quick throw and caught. And that's going to be a gain. That probably looks like will be a first down. So gives, and that's Marrero. That's going to give Charleston some breathing room, as that's Marrero's third reception of the game now. He has about 17 yards on that, and a big first down that gives Charleston some breathing room. Howard 4-for-4 through the air with 65 yards and a touchdown. That was Justin David on the tackle. As now man going in motion. And it's going to be snapped, handed off. No, it's faked. It's thrown out and caught in the, and that's going to be another first down for the Golden Eagles. And that pass is complete to number 6, Bossmans. From Pembroke Pines, Florida. Bossman, that's going to result in a first down. And that is going to do it for the first quarter here. So we're tied up at 7 here at Dickerson Stadium and Lake and Ray Field. Great rivalry matchup. We're going to be back. You're watching Yellow Jacket Football on the MEC Network, brought to you by Video Productions.
In NCAA Division II, community engagement is an initiative at all 25 national championships because student-athletes want to give back while competing for a national title. Over the course of the year, Division II student-athletes have an opportunity to leave a lasting impression in local communities throughout the country. Whether Division II student-athletes are volunteering at hospitals, schools, after-school care programs, foster homes, or retirement villages, they make a difference in the lives of others. In Division II, we rise to the opportunity and make community engagement ours.
Choosing health coverage for your family, your employees, and your company is one of the most important decisions you can make. The health plan proudly supports our active and healthy communities and has been your most trusted carrier for over 40 years.
And we're back, tied up at 7, starting the second quarter, as it's a two-back shotgun formation coming up for the Golden Eagles. Man in motion, that's Marrero, and it's handed off right side. Looking to get room, and he does find a little bit. That is number 26, Alex Brink, the senior from Logansport, Indiana, with the run, and that's going to be, so that'll be 2nd and 6 now coming up for the Golden Eagles. That was Cameron Vargas that made the tackle. As it snapped, it's handed off. It's a fake, and it's thrown out to the flats, and that's going to be close to a first down. Right with the reception. And he usually makes he's usually good for 1 or 2 catches a game. That one will make it the 3rd first down on this drive for the Golden Eagles. All 3 first downs that have come through the air. So it's going to be a fresh set now for the Golden Eagles as Wright motions. It's handed off up the middle. And it's carry. Brink's going to power through there and get about 8.
Brink on the carry. Let's go tackled by Cameron Vargas.
Vargas on the tackle, so that's going to make it 2nd and about 2 coming up. That's a 2nd rush for Brink. 2nd tackle today for Vargas. Has a man in motion, and it's going to be snapped. No, it's a throw, and it's caught. In the flat, they're going to say it's caught, so that'll be a gain of about 1 and close. There, officials discussing. Originally, they were motioning for the chains to move, but I think they're going to call that a first down. So that's Marrero's 4th reception today, and the 2nd that's going to be for a first down.
That's bullshit by that official.
And State not happy with that call. It's going to be a 1st and 10. And it's snapped. And they're going to go for the deep ball again. They're going to Marrero. And it's batted and out of, deflected out of bounds. So that'll make it 2nd and 10. Justin David on the defense. And that is the 1st incompletion today for Javonte Howard. 7 of 8 through the air, 89 yards and a touchdown so far for the quarterback. As now it'll be 2nd and 10. And it's handed off right, looking for room. He has some, but a flag. And we'll see what the call. It's in the vicinity of holding. And that's exactly what it's going to be, so this one will come back. That's going to be holding, going against number 2, Josh Brown, the sophomore. The senior, I'm sorry. So that's going to make it now 2nd and 20 coming up for the Golden Eagles. As they're going man in motion, it's going to be a pass thrown and caught in the middle, and it's good catch, looking for room, and he's going to get a few yards. And that'll be a good game, but it's still going to be 3rd and about 15. So now, and that was number 22, Avery Scott, the sophomore that made the tackle on that play. That was Marrero who picked up his 5th catch of the game. You can see they rely on him in a lot of situations for good reasons. He's a heck of an athlete. As it's now 3rd and 15, they need to get past the 39. They're going deep and overthrown. So that will make it now 4th and 15 coming up for the Golden Eagles. And it looked like they were going for Heron again. So the pack will come out to punt. And that's going way back, and that's going to take a little bit of a Charleston bounce, and it'll stop at about the 8-yard line. So now the Yellow Jackets will start 1st and 10 on the 8-yard line. So the two teams discussing here right now as we're here, and what a day it is. I mean, and a lot of good things that you can say, of course, a lot of good things with these programs. And, of course, one player I'd like to highlight on the offensive line, thank you, we got Brian Shepherd here with the bringing some stats in. But wanted to say first off, for as you see with Westford or for Charleston, one player to watch on their offensive line, number 65, Ethan Wolford. As Wolford, who's local, he played for Belfry High School in Kentucky, and Belfry, who has won 8 state championships since 2003 under Philip Haywood and Matt Varney and some of the coaching staff that stuck together a long time. But Wolford, the lone underclassman that starts for the University of Charleston and, of course, is known for his leadership, comes back to Belfry in the summer and leads and trains with the younger guys. So definitely a good addition for that Charleston team, as that one's handed off to Butler on the left side, and he's going to get a yard or two. So now State right back on the line. And that's going to be Jantois, Felder, and Baker in the backfield. And it snapped. Jantois hands it off. Felder looking for a hole, and he's going to get one or two. Felder on the carry. So that's going to make it about third and seven, maybe third and eight. More of a third and eight coming up here as the Yellow Jackets will need to get past the 19-yard line to get the first down. That was Akayenzu on the tackle. So now this will making some adjustments in the backfield. And it's snapped. Jantois fakes the run. He's going to go downfield and overthrown.
Jantois pass intended for number 14, Juwan Bunch.
So that was intended for Juwan Bunch. And that's the thing. They've had him in stride, but just so far been overthrown a couple times here tonight. As that's going to be fourth down coming up. So now it's going to be fourth and down. Schmidt out to punt. And it's up. And that's going to be bounced back. And they'll touch it. So Charleston will take over. They'll start on their own 47-yard line. So now looking at it, I think looking at it from the perspective of Charleston side, it looks like, I mean, they've been heavily in rhythm on the passing end, 95 yards, 8 of 10 through the air right now and a touchdown. Rushing, I mean, they've had some decent, I mean, they have a total of 18 yards on 7 carries on the rushing end. But I think I expect we'll see them continue to try that downfield attack that they've been doing. They had an incredible reception as Heron scored a touchdown earlier, and I wouldn't be surprised to see them continue to try that. But I think for West Virginia State, I think they're at the point. Jantois his guys are getting open, but I think it's just finding ways to hit them in stride. And Jantois, who wasn't expected to be in this situation tonight, quarterback Donovan Riddick, who had an injury last week and is out, which is very unfortunate because you have one of the all-time great contributors to this West Virginia State program. And now it's but Jantois stepping in there tonight. He's 7 of 13, 66 yards. He has a touchdown completion to Baker, but also an interception. As now it's going to be a pitch on the outside, and that's Marrero on the carry, and he's going to get drugged down. And that's number one, Jai Martin, the sophomore that got back there to make the play. So that'll be a gain of about one. That's three tackles now for Jai Martin. Second and nine as Marrero goes in motion again, and it's going to be handed off. They're going to go around the right side. Brink's going to carry it, and he's going to get two or three. So now third and about six coming up for the, Golden Eagles. Here they need to get past the Yellow Jackets' 43-yard line to get the first down. As they come out, bunch formation, Marrero in motion, and it's going to be snapped and thrown across the middle, and it's deflected. That was intended for Marrero and deflected by number two, Christian Thompson, the senior safety, and that's going to bring up fourth and six now. As they come out to punt in this one. Juwan Bunch back to return for the Yellow Jackets, and Pack coming in for the Golden Eagles. And snaps up. Pack kicks it. And that's going to go way back. Bunch calls for fair catch. That's going to take a roll. It started to take a Golden Eagle roll and then started rolling back in favor of the Jackets. So they stopped it. So the Yellow Jackets will start with the ball first and 10 on their own 7. Of course, the Yellow Jackets, Coach Pennington, who played football for at West Virginia University, played for Rich Rodriguez. Rich Rod, who led Glenville State to a national championship game in 1993 before going to WVU, as now it's going to be first and 10 coming up for the Yellow Jackets. As Jantois making an adjustment at the line. That's going to be him and Felder back there. And it snapped, handed off. They're going to go to Felder up the middle. He's going to spin and gain about 4 or 5. That's Akayensu and Floyd on the tackle. And Akayensu, I love his demeanor out there watching him play. Second and 4, it's going to Felder again. He spins, pushing, but barely able to get. Well, he might have gotten 2 more. And we're going to see what the effect, because there's, well, something big if he gets 2 more, but I'm not going to say it just yet. It's also worth noting, Willie Floyd, 5 tackles so far tonight for the Golden Eagles. And Felder has done it. Felder has the congratulations to him. He is the first 1,000-yard rusher for West Virginia State since 1988. Big congratulations to Joel Felder. As he gets the first down for the Yellow Jackets.
He's brought down by Aiden Miller.
Brought down by Miller, so a fresh set of downs coming up for the Yellow Jackets. And if I'm the Yellow Jackets, I try to take up a lot of time on this drive. I mean, of course, I mean, you know how explosive that Golden Eagle offense is, as Felder carries up the middle, big hole, left side, he has room, first down, Felder gets up to the 50. A huge gain of 28 yards, and Felder will get another first down.
That's a gain of 29 yards.
29 yards, so they are in the territory of the Golden Eagles now, as it's going to be first and 10. Felder up to 86 yards on the ground tonight. Again, the first 1,000-yard rusher at West Virginia State since 1988. As now Jantois rolls out, pass complete, and that's going to be Airy, and he'll get a gain of 7. Gilkey on the tackle. Gilkey, you had an interception earlier in this one, and that's going to make it second and about 3 coming up. That'll be Gilkey's 4th tackle of the game. Airy now with 3 catches for 37 yards. As now adjustment, that's Pessoa in the backfield now instead of Felder with Jantois. And it's going to be fake to Pessoa. Jantois is going to go deep. And, oh, just off the head of the defender. Jantois is trying to get it downfield there, but it went off Gilkey's head. So that's going to make it 3rd. And not a bad play call at all. I mean, you have to, against a team with the caliber of Charleston, you have to take some risks. And that's one that they took. And so now 3rd and 2 coming up. And it's going to be handed off to Pessoa, and he's going to get a first down up the middle. And that was big number 78, Brody Sipple, that had a great block on the right side, able to plow, and Pessoa able to plow through for the first down on his fourth carry of the game. So now Pessoa and Jantois in the backfield. As man goes in motion, Butler does, and Pessoa is drugged down. And that's number 17, Kayshawn Beasley, the 6'2", 215-pound junior on the tackle. So no gain on that play, and that was excellent. That's the thing what Beasley shows. You don't always have to make this humongous hit. I mean, I feel like in a lot of cases players are losing the fundamentals, and Beasley with a great fundamental tackle on that. As it's now Jantois rolling out. He's going to go downfield for Bunch and overthrown. So now it's going to be third and 10 coming up for the Yellow Jackets, that who are 5 of 8 so far tonight on third down conversions. West Virginia State with 165 yards tonight, 74 through the air, 91 on the ground, compared to Charleston, 95 through the air, 22 on the ground. As Jones is on and going out to be a receiver, pressure coming. It's a screen pass and caught. What a hit. And that was number 4, Willie Floyd, the junior, that got back there. He was ready for that one. He didn't just make that play on the field. He made that play in the film room. He was ready to see for that one to come, as now that's going to be a – and that's Floyd's sixth tackle tonight. So that's going to be 4th and 12 coming up for the Yellow Jackets. And they will bring the punting unit on, led by Schmidt. And it's back. Schmidt kicks it. And fair catch signal made. And that's going to be spotted at the 1. A good job by that punt team, as that is number 30, Tim Samford, the sophomore, that rushed back there to make the play. And now the Golden Eagles will start with the ball. 1st and 10 coming from the 1-yard line here in the second quarter. We've been back and forth in this rivalry matchup as State got on the board first with an 8-yard pass to Nate from Jantois to Nate Baker. Then Charleston would get on the board with a 47-yard touchdown pass, a deep ball thrown to Heron, which he made a lot of concentration on that reception. Again, as now it's going to be 1st and 10 coming up from the 1. I feel like both teams have been pinned back in their own end zones quite a bit sometimes. That's handed off. Wright has room. He's going to take it and get about 35 on the play. So Wright with a train of steam on the left side. Big hole opens up for him, and he's going to get up. And Wright has surpassed 12. Or he's close to surpassing 1,200 yards on the season, as now they're going to go right back to that same play right again. Chain's not even able to get set yet, and that's going to be a gain of about 7. That was a 34-yard shoot. No, that's about 10. I'm sorry. He got another first down. So Wright really picking up a train of steam here in the second quarter. They fake it this time. They go for the deep ball, or they go for the again, and then that's going to be incomplete. So 2nd and 10 coming up. So Wright with 44 yards rushing on this drive, and it's going to be 2nd and 10 coming up. And it snapped, thrown back, thrown over the middle, nearly picked off, but got it through there, and that's going to be a big first down play for the – and that's complete to Marrero. So the Golden Eagles catching some rhythm on this drive, and That will now make it first and 10 on the West Virginia State 30. As it snapped, he drops back. He's going to go across the middle. Pass just too high and incomplete. That'll make it second down. Marrero with 6 catches for 50 yards so far on the night. As now it's going to be second and 10. Ball snapped, handed off, and a huge hole up the middle for Brink. He's going to get the first down. So Alex Brink, his fourth carry, and he surpasses 25 yards rushing as the Golden Eagles are right back on the line on this first and 10 from the red zone. And it's going to be they're going to go for the end zone. Caught! Touchdown, Golden Eagles. And that was number 15, Muzin, the junior, that made the catch. And double coverage as well. So that will be a touchdown for him. As now Javonte Howard, 10 of 15, 137 yards, and 2 touchdowns on the night. McCutcheon on to attempt the extra point as Charleston leads for the first time in this one. It's up and is good. So with 1:43 remaining in the first half, it's 14-7. University of Charleston in the lead. We're going to take a break and come back. You're watching Yellow Jacket Football on the MEC Network, brought to you by Video Productions.
Life, things aren't scripted.
If you're an athlete, we need people like you and translate those skills to officiate.
You can get a lot out of it.
It happens in every town, in every game.
We never have a perfect game, but the rewards always outweigh the negativities.
Levi Paxton in to kick off for UC, who just scored on a touchdown pass. As now it's Muzon that caught that, and the ball's kicked deep, and that's going to go into the hands of Monroe. He's looking for a seam up the middle and gets to about the 30. And that is where the Yellow Jackets will start. So it'll be interesting to see where they try to go with under 2 minutes. If I'm the Yellow Jackets, I think I try to open up the short passing game some. The deep ball, they've had the guys in space, but just hadn't quite been able to get it there, as that's going to be Felder and Jantois in the backfield for the Yellow Jackets. As the Golden Eagles quickly get out of that five-man front. Adjust their line, so it's going to be first and 10. And it's snapped. Jantois goes across the middle and passes incomplete. No flags, so that'll be second down. That was intended for Jawan Bunch. So now on the second down, and right now, Jantois 9 of 18 through the air. As it'll be second and 10. Right now, West Virginia State has 2 timeouts remaining. Then they need to get past that was Preston who broke up the pass, and they will need to get past their own 42 to get the first down. Making Jantois making an adjustment to the play. And he'll give it to Felder. He'll take it right side. Felder for room, plenty of room, and he's going to get out of bounds, but not before a flag falls. And that will probably be holding against the Yellow Jackets, and that it is. So that will negate the run and make it second and 20. Coming up. So Felder, who's close to 100 yards in the first half, had a big game. Again, surpassed 1,000 yards on the season, becoming the first rusher for 1,000-yard rusher that this school has had for West Virginia State since 1988. As now it's going to be second and 20 here with 1:26 remaining. And the Yellow Jackets need to get past their own 42 to get a first down. And a timeout called by the Yellow Jackets, their second of the half. We'll take it with them. You're watching Yellow Jacket Football on the MEC Network, brought to you by Video Productions.
In NCAA Division II, community engagement is an initiative at all 25 national championships because student-athletes want to give back while competing for a national title. Over the course of the year, Division II student-athletes have an opportunity to leave a lasting impression in local communities throughout the country. Whether Division II student-athletes are volunteering at hospitals, schools, after-school care programs, foster homes, or retirement villages, they make a difference in the lives of others. In Division II, we rise to the opportunity and make community engagement ours.
Choosing health coverage for your family, your employees, and your company is one of the most important decisions you can make. The health plan proudly supports our active and healthy communities and has been your most trusted carrier for over 40 years. We are here for your family. We are here for your business. We'll be here for you when you need us most, because your health coverage is our priority. The health plan, here for you.
And we're back. It's going to be second and 20 coming up for the Yellow Jackets here, as they just got called for a holding penalty. And Jantois looking to throw. Jantois, he's going to break through a tackler. He's going to run it, get out of bounds, and brought down. And the flags come. That's probably going to be a late hit. Look at that again. He goes flying out as that's going to be a personal foul, so that will give West Virginia State a first down here with 1:17 remaining in the first half. That's going to make it first and 10. The Yellow Jackets have one timeout remaining. The Golden Eagles have two. And it's going to be Felder carrying it, and he's met right in the backfield. That looks like Daxton Gallagher that made the tackle, the 6'1", 235-pound sophomore. Second down and 11. So second down now. And it snapped, flags fly. So now that's going to make it second and 16 coming up.
Second
So now it's going to be second and 16. So now there we go. I was working on the computer, get my stat program back up, or our stat program back up. So second and 16 coming up for the Yellow Jackets here as the clock continues to run. And it's snapped. Jantois, he's going to go downfield and overthrown. Pass is intended for Airy, so that's going to make it third down now, and the Yellow Jackets need to get past the Charleston 47-yard line to get the first down here with under 30 to go in the first half. Now Jantois dropping back. It's thrown to Felder over the middle. Blocks start to form. Felder gets through. Felder carries it. He gets the first down and out of bounds. Or he may be we'll see where that official spots it. So that is going to be fourth and about one. Coming up, that's Felder's second reception of the game. So with 16 seconds to go in the half, it's going to be fourth and two coming up for the Yellow Jackets here as they are on the 49 of the Golden Eagles. And whistles blow. And a timeout taken. So timeout, that'll be the first timeout for Charleston. No fourth down attempts today for the Yellow Jackets, but just to compare right now, just to look at the team's breakdowns, 182 yards for the Yellow Jackets, 86 through the air, 96 on the ground, 216 for the Golden Eagles, 137 through the air, 79 on the ground. Third down efficiency, the Golden Eagles are only 1 of 4. The Yellow Jackets 5 of 10. And when it comes to yards per play, it's 8 per play for the Golden Eagles and 4.3 per play for the Yellow Jackets. So I think right now, the Golden Eagles, you could see just the experience and play of Howard in the backfield just standing out. I feel like he's done. He's remained in stride. He's thrown a couple touchdown strikes. And then for Jantois, this is a new level for him. I feel like he's stepped up and done some good things despite just the challenge that this presents for him. I think in the second half, if he can try to hit, because he's had a couple guys open downfield, as he steps up under center, they're going to try to draw Charleston off sides. Jantois. And West Virginia State will use their last time out of the half. So they went up and tried to draw them off sides. So for a big fourth down coming up. But, of course, the story, these two rivals played last season with Charleston winning, or with West Virginia State winning 42-35. And they've had a great series, as Charleston, though, has won 8 of the last 12 in it. And no doubt about it, of course, you look at what Charleston's done. They're looking to try to win this conference outright. If the scenario for them with a Charleston victory today, that would seal the conference for them. However, if Charleston were to lose and Fairmont State were to win, then they would have a 50-50 split for the conference titles. So the best scenario, of course, for Charleston is what they're looking to do is win. But, of course, the Yellow Jackets, and, again, a program that struggled greatly prior to Coach Pennington's arrival in 2017. And now, I mean, has been a team that has been highly competitive in the Mountain East Conference. And even though I know this isn't what they desired this season, what they had back, they had a great 4-1 start, but then have dropped 4 in a row, could certainly salvage some things with a big win over Charleston tonight as they're bringing in Schmidt to punt on this fourth down. And that's going to go way up in the air. And that's going to take a state bounce and go back to about the 9-yard line. And that's where it'll be spotted. We'll see if the
9-yard line of UC.
See what the officials calls of that. So that'll be, so we'll have an offensive play coming up as Charleston, they do have two timeouts remaining. West Virginia State is out of timeouts at this point. So this will make it first and 10 on the 9-yard line coming up for the Golden Eagles. And it looks like they're just going to come out and kneel it on this play. And that's what they do. So that will wrap up the first half here on Senior Day at Dickerson Stadium, Lake and Ray Field. Your score, Charleston leads West Virginia State 14-7 going into halftime. We're going to take a break and come back. You're watching Yellow Jacket Football on the MEC Network, brought to you by Video Productions.
Health coverage for your family, your employees, and your company is one of the most important decisions you can make. The health plan proudly supports our active and healthy communities and has been your most trusted carrier for over 40 years. We are here for your family. We are here for your business. We'll be here for you when you need us most, because your health coverage is our priority. The health plan, here for you.
In life, things aren't scripted.
If you're an athlete, we need people like you and translate those skills to officiating.
You can get a lot out of it.
It happens in every town, in every game.
We never have a perfect game, but the rewards always outweigh the negativities.
In NCAA Division II, student athletes leave a lasting impression on their communities. That's because Division II student athletes want to make a difference and truly be part of their surrounding communities. Through community engagement, thousands of student athletes from various backgrounds interact with community members who view them as role models. This interaction leaves a positive and perhaps even life-changing impression on all those involved. In Division II, we rise to the opportunity and make community engagement ours.
What are you working for? Do you want to pursue your athletic potential while earning a degree that will benefit you for a lifetime? Do you want to play at the highest level in your sport? Do you want to be a champion? That's what the proud members of the Mountain East Conference are advancing toward every day. Providing opportunities and pursuing excellence. The Mountain East Conference.
health coverage for your family, your employees, and your company is one of the most important decisions you can make. The health plan proudly supports our active and healthy communities and has been your most trusted carrier for over 40 years. We are here for your family. We are here for your business. We'll be here for you when you need us most, because your health coverage is our priority. The health plan, here for you.
In life, things aren't scripted.
If you're an athlete, we need people like you and translate those skills to officiate.
You can get a lot out of it.
It happens in every town, in every game.
We never have a perfect game, but the rewards always outweigh the negativities.
In NCAA Division II, student athletes leave a lasting impression on their communities. That's because Division II student athletes want to make a difference and truly be part of their surrounding communities. Through community engagement, thousands of student athletes from various backgrounds interact with community members who view them as role models. This interaction leaves a positive and perhaps even life-changing impression on all those involved. In Division II, we rise to the opportunity and make community engagement ours.
What are you working for? Do you want to pursue your athletic potential while earning a degree that will benefit you for a lifetime? Do you want to play at the highest level in your sport? Do you want to be a champion? That's what the proud members of the Mountain East Conference are advancing toward every day. Providing opportunities and pursuing excellence. The Mountain East Conference.
Health coverage for your family, your employees, and your company is one of the most important decisions you can make. The health plan proudly supports our active and healthy communities and has been your most trusted carrier for over 40 years. We are here for your family. We are here for your business. We'll be here for you when you need us most, because your health coverage is our priority. The health plan, here for you.
In life, things aren't scripted.
If you're an athlete, we need people like you and translate those skills to officiate.
You can get a lot out of it.
It happens in every town, in every game.
We never have a perfect game, but the rewards always outweigh the negativities.
In NCAA Division II, student athletes leave a lasting impression on their communities. That's because Division II student athletes want to make a difference and truly be part of their surrounding communities. Through community engagement, thousands of student athletes from various backgrounds interact with community members who view them as role models. This interaction leaves a positive and perhaps even life-changing impression on all those involved. In Division II, we rise to the opportunity and make community engagement ours.
What are you working for? Do you want to pursue your athletic potential while earning a degree that will benefit you for a lifetime? Do you want to play at the highest level in your sport? Do you want to be a champion? That's what the proud members of the Mountain East Conference are advancing toward every day. Providing opportunities and pursuing excellence. The Mountain East Conference.
Health coverage for your family, your employees, and your company is one of the most important decisions you can make. The health plan proudly supports our active and healthy communities and has been your most trusted carrier for over 40 years. We are here for your family. We are here for your business. We'll be here for you when you need us most, because your health coverage is our priority. The health plan, here for you.
In life, things aren't scripted.
If you're an athlete, we need people like you and translate those skills to officiate.
You can get a lot out of it.
It happens in every town, in every game.
We never have a perfect game, but the rewards always outweigh the negativities.
In NCAA Division II, student-athletes leave a lasting impression on their communities. That's because Division II student-athletes want to make a difference and truly be part of their surrounding communities. Through community engagement, thousands of student-athletes from various backgrounds interact with community members who view them as role models. This interaction leaves a positive and perhaps even life-changing impression on all those involved. In Division II, we rise to the opportunity and make community engagement ours.
What are you working for? Do you want to pursue your athletic potential while earning a degree that will benefit you for a lifetime? Do you want to play at the highest level in your sport? Do you want to be a champion? That's what the proud members of the Mountain East Conference are advancing toward every day. Providing opportunities and pursuing excellence. The Mountain East Conference.
And we're back. It's 14-7. Charleston leading West Virginia State here at halftime. We're just under a minute until we get to start the second half. But just looking at some numbers here, first off, the rushing yards as Charleston has 96 compared to 75 for West Virginia State. And then you look at it through the air and just looking at those particular numbers. The air is actually, we'll talk a little bit about the ground game, because they were both teams I felt like were able to have some success through it. And I think that, you know, looking at it, I think they can potentially continue that. You know, I mean, for Charleston, Wright had 57 of those yards, Brink had 29 of them. So I think that they definitely had a good balance, and Felder had 85 in the first half, including a big 29-yard run. But then on through the air, it was 137 for Charleston and 86 for West Virginia State. Howard picked up through the air, a great game for Javonte Howard so far. He had 137. He's 10 of 15 through the air right now, and I mean, he's having two touchdown passes to two different players, so he stepped up and really, you know, made a difference. I mean, Howard's a good quarterback as it is. I mean, and he's hit two. I mean, he picked up his 25th touchdown pass of the season, so definitely a good showing from Javonte. And I mean, also breaking that down just a little bit further, he also, congratulations to Javonte Howard for picking up his 30th touchdown pass as well. And Jantois come in for State. He's 10 of 20 as it's kicked off. And it's Marrero left side trying to get around the corner, and he does get close to the 40. So a good return by Marrero, who had 6 receptions in the first half for 50 yards. So it'll be the 36-yard line that West Virginia State will, or I'm sorry, that UC will start with the football. Now, I think if I'm State this second half, honestly, I was more concerned looking at the passing game for UC. And, I mean, of course, Wright is an incredible runner, but I'd definitely try to be prepared and try to stop those deep passes they like to go to, as Man goes in motion, Marrero, and it's going to be handed off right up the middle. He has a train of steam, stays on his feet, and gets the first down. So, right, that's going to be a gain of about 15 and a fresh set of downs coming up for the Golden Eagles, who with a win today could clinch the conference championship outright. So now that's going to be a first and 10 at midfield. And it's going to be handed off. Javon Wright again. Why not? He's going to gain 3. And congratulations to Wright, who has passed 1,200 yards on the season. He had 1,175 last year and 17 scores. He has 1,213 scores on this year. Passes fake, thrown, and caught. First down and stays in bounds. Good show of agility on that. That's Bussman that catches it. That was Blake that made the stop. So now that's going to be first and 10 as the Golden Eagles move deeper into Yellow Jacket territory. It's faked. It's a pass. They're going to Marrero. Caught for the first down. And that's going to put them deep in West Virginia State territory. So Marrero, his 7th reception on the game. And it's a big one here, as that's going to make it first and goal at the 10 coming up for the Golden Eagles. So good protection on that play. That's 7 catches for 76 yards, as Howard's now 12 of 14 for 174 through the air. And it snapped. He's going to drop back. It's going to be thrown to the end zone and deflected. And that was number 2, Avery Scott, on the defense. That pass was intended for Heron, who scored a touchdown earlier. So that's going to be 2nd and goal now from the 10. And Marrero in motion. It's snapped. It's going to be handed off to Wright up the middle, and he's going to get 4 or 5. Running off that big senior left guard, number 71, Barnabas Banning, the 360-pound senior. As now that's going to make it 3rd and goal from about the 6. Right now the Golden Eagles 1 of 4 on 3rd down conversions. And it snapped. He's going to drop back, thrown to the end zone, caught. Touchdown, Golden Eagles. And that's number 34, Nico Koski, the 5'10", 230-pound junior on the catch. So 3 touchdown passes today for Javonte Howard. Koski, the big fullback, comes from Steubenville, Ohio. And now that's going to make it a 2-score game here. And they're going to come in and kick it. Flag down. And that's going to be offsides on the defense. And they're going to decline that. So they'll kick it again. And it snapped. It's up. Looks good. It is good. So with 12:19 to go, it's 21-7, Charleston over West Virginia State. We're going to take a break and come back. You're watching Yellow Jacket Football on the MEC Network, brought to you by Video Productions.
Life, things aren't scripted.
If you're an athlete, we need people like you and translate those skills to officiating.
You can get a lot out of it.
It happens in every town, in every game.
We never have a perfect game, but the rewards always outweigh the negativities.
And we're back. So Koski picks up his fourth touchdown reception of the season, as now it's 21-7. And Howard right now 13 of 19, 180 yards, three touchdowns on the night. As now they're going back to kick off. That's number 85, Levi Paxton, into kick. And Monroe and company leading the way for the Yellow Jackets. And I think if I'm West Virginia State, this drive, I just try to, I mean, see, we'll see how they adjust. But, I mean, I try to keep attacking. I mean, they've hung in there so far. So now it's kicked off, and that's going to go out of bounds. So that'll give State some decent field position. But, again, missing Donovan Riddick, over 50 career touchdown passes he's had. One of the all-time greats to come through this program from the quarterback position, and he's been out today. So definitely, and Jantois getting his first chance to step in there, as that's going to be now in a game like this, as that's going to be first and 10 coming up for the Yellow Jackets. They will start after the penalty, the kickoff out of bounds. They will start from their own 35. Butler in motion, and it's going to be pitched. That's Pessoa, and he's going to carry it left side and get nowhere. That is number one, Miller, on the tackle for the Golden Eagles. So now Miller, Aiden Miller, good job today. Five tackles, three that were those unassisted. So now second down coming up for the Yellow Jackets. And it snapped, faked. And he's going to go throw, and they're going to call that incomplete. So passes, it was a little bit of a slow pass getting there. I couldn't quite tell if Ari had had possession, but I think they're going to call that it hit the ground. So now that'll make it third and about nine coming up for the Yellow Jackets, as they are 5 of 10 today on third down conversions. As you can imagine, Charleston looking to send the, no, they're going to drop in coverage. Three men rushing, Jantois under pressure and gets sacked. So a nice play in the backfield. So Charleston, they acted like that was Dyson Yulee, a nice play in the backfield. But they were able to confuse the offensive line. They lined up with three guys and then faked a blitz up the middle. Then were shocked when they rushed three guys. They were expecting to pick up some blitzers. Those guys ended up dropping back into coverage, and they were able to get in the backfield and make the play. So Schmidt out to punt, and it's going to be a fair catch. So Charleston will take over first and 10, starting on their own 36-yard line. So not a good start to the second half for the Yellow Jackets, just trying to get something going, as just they were able to shut down the run on the first play and then get that sack. So now it'll be a first down. But again, of course, I mean, if I'm Charleston, I'd say Charleston's going to be gunning heavily to try to make this a three-score game on this drive and force West Virginia State with a new quarterback in to try to play, you know, have to play from deeply behind. But of course, if I'm State, I mean, I think you have to look at, there's some sense of optimism. I mean, they have been back there on some of those passes, but I think that's been the big source of damage for the Golden Eagles has been the passing game. They've had three different guys catch a touchdown pass today, and that's typically how they are. They spread the ball around a lot. They have several guys, some that have that are like Heron that are highly known, Heron and Marrero, for their hands, and others that, well, others like that have caught the passes today, like Koski, that don't catch it as much, but I think are very underrated with how they're looked at. So I think, I mean, but I think if I'm State, I think that you could definitely come out there and try to draft a quick scheme to try to cause a little bit of confusion up there. And still a lot of reasons to be optimistic at this point. Just got to find a way to make something happen to get that ball back and then get on the scoreboard again. As now they're coming out, shotgun two backs here on this first down. And it's snapped, and it's faked, it's thrown, and caught by Wright, and he's going to get maybe a yard, a couple yards. Samford and Fannin in on the tackle for the Yellow Jackets, so that's going to make it second and seven coming up, and it's faked, thrown, and caught. Oh, no, pass was dropped. Pass was intended for Muzon. Malzahn, who had a touchdown pass earlier, touchdown reception. So now that's going to make it third and seven as the Golden Eagles need to get past their own 42-yard line to get the first half. They are 2 of 5 so far tonight on third down conversions. The last one, though, they were able to pick up a touchdown pass off of. And it's snapped, and it's going to be a screen caught right, plenty of room. He's going to juke back and get close to midfield, getting a first down. So they were able to read the West Virginia State rush and make some room for Wright, and that's now going to be a first down. Wright on, I believe, his third reception. So now Howard, 15 of 22 for 196. And it's handed off to Wright, and he's going to gain two or three. Thompson on the tackle. So that'll be a gain of three. Wright now approaching, not Wright, with 10 rushes for 81 yards on the night to go along with his three receptions for 22. So second and seven coming up for the Golden Eagles. Man in motion in the backfield. And it's snapped. They're going to go to right again. Right side. He's going to go off tackle and get maybe one. Tim Samford on the stop. So they'll be third down coming up here. As the Golden Eagles need to get past the 42-yard line of the Yellow Jackets to get the first down. As the Yellow Jackets are again showing blitz. I wouldn't be surprised if that's a fake after they threw the screen like they did the last time. And he's caught in the backfield, but he's right there. I think that was Scott that got there to make that play. A good wrap-up tackle, and that's what the Yellow Jackets needed, and it's going to be fourth down now. As the punting unit comes on. So now Pack will come out to kick. Jawan Bunch back deep. And that was Alex Brink that made that catch. As now it's punted. And that's going to go back to Bunch, and that's going to take a roll. A Yellow Jack or a A Golden Eagle roll back to the two is where the ball will be spotted. So now that's going to put West Virginia State pinned back deep in their own territory. Honestly, I mean, if I'm the Yellow Jackets, I stick to the running game to Felder and try to get some of those short passes or passes across the middle going, as that's been something that, I mean, I feel like they've had a little bit of success with. They've tried the deep ball quite a bit, but I just don't think the chemistry is there at this point with the new quarterback, as that's thrown and caught by Johnson. I think it did. Might have been knocked out. Okay, it was knocked out of bounds by number 12, Gilkey, the senior. Ashton Gilkey's been all over the place today. He's made a couple plays, special teams. He's had an interception in the end zone, and now a good breakup there, as that's going to make it 2nd and 10 coming up. It snapped, and they're attacking the A-gaps hard. It's going up the middle to Pessoa. So that's going to make it 3rd and 9 coming up now from that's Gallagher on the tackle. So the Yellow Jackets will need to get past their own 13-yard line to get the first down. We'll see what they draw up here. That's Felder in the backfield now with Jantois. Jantois, he's going to hand it off. Felder, a little bit of room on the left side. He's going to juke, but not get a lot, as he's going to get a couple. So that's going to make it 4th down and set up a situation for the Yellow Jackets where they will be punting from their own end zone. So they'll have it on. That gets them out to the 5. So Schmidt will likely have to make a quick play here from the end zone, as I'm sure the Golden Eagles will be sending the forces to try to block that one. And it snaps. Schmidt takes it. It's kicked. It's a high but not a deep punt, and that's going to go out of bounds, giving the Golden Eagles possession of the ball on about the 30-yard line of the, well, we'll see where it went out, about the closer to the 25-yard line of the of West Virginia State. So they will get the ball with excellent field position, a 21-yard punt by Schmidt, and it'll now be 1st and 10 for the Golden Eagles from the 26-yard line of West Virginia State. So here in the third quarter, it's been mostly the Golden Eagles, as it snapped, handed off right up the middle, train of steam, and he's going to get 4. So Wright getting closer and closer to 100 yards. He's at 85 right now. So 2nd and 6 coming up for the Golden Eagles. And it's going to be thrown, caught, and he's going to juke the defender and get knocked out of bounds. Ball came out, but it was out either way. So that'll make it, and that'll be the 17th pass completion today for Howard, as he will now be 17-24 through the air, and he passes 200 yards on that pass completion. So first and 10 coming up. That's Bossman's 3rd catch. Tackle by David, and it's going to be a run and a gain of about 5, maybe 6. Right, the ball carrier. Vargas on the tackle. So that'll make it 2nd and 5. Right up to 90 yards now, as it snapped, handed off right again, takes it up the middle, and he's going to get about three. So that'll make it third and about two. So this again, this will be a big play. This is where you want to strike if you're the Yellow Jackets. Try to get a good push. As you imagine, they'll probably be coming with the run again to Wright or Brink. So it looks like Brink's in the backfield. It's gonna be a Wildcat, and he's tackled, and that's what it takes. Good job by West Virginia State getting back there to make the play, and that's going to make it fourth and one now. Witcher with the stop, and we're going to see what the Golden Eagles decide to do, and it looks like they're going to take a chance on this on fourth and one. And they're coming in with their power package. And it's going to be handed off, and that'll be a first down. Actually, that'll be a touchdown for Wright. So his 14th touchdown of the year. He also passes 100 yards on the night on that play, and now that makes this a three-score game with 3:41 to go in the third quarter. So McCutcheon on to attempt the extra point, the senior. And it snaps. McCutcheon's kicks up. It looks good. It is good. So with 3:41 to go in the third, it's 28-7. Charleston leading West Virginia State. We're going to take a break and come back. You're watching Yellow Jacket Football on the MEC Network, brought to you by Video Production.
In NCAA Division II, community engagement is an initiative at all 25 national championships because student-athletes want to give back while competing for a national title. Over the course of the year, Division II student-athletes have an opportunity to leave a lasting impression in local communities throughout the country. Whether Division II student-athletes are volunteering at hospitals, schools, after-school care programs, foster homes, or retirement villages, they make a difference in the lives of others. In Division II, we rise to the opportunity and make community engagement ours.
Choosing health coverage for your family, your employees, and your company is one of the most important decisions you can make. The health plan proudly supports our active and healthy communities and has been your most trusted carrier for over 40 years. We are here for your family. We are here for your business. We'll be here for you when you need us most, because your health coverage is our priority. The health plan, here for you.
And we're back. Chavon Wright up the middle for 5 yards for the touchdown. And with 3:41 to go here in the third quarter. And now the Golden Eagles will be kicking off. And I think that was the first time either team has gone for it today on fourth down. As now that's kicked back. Monroe will get it at the 10. And he's going to look for room left side. And nearly breaks through the defender, but brought down nicely. It's a 25. And that was number 11, Tommy Ashworth, on the tackle, the 5'11 junior from coming in from Clarksburg, from Copenhagen, Denmark, is Ashworth. So. He came from Fork Union as well, as that's going to be a first and 10 now coming up for State. Let's see what they put together on this drive. It's going to be a screen pass to Airy. It's Cotton. He's met right at the line. This Golden Eagle defense really tightening up. That's number 23, Trice, on the tackle. From Christian County, Kentucky. There's a transfer from Lindsey Wilson. And that'll make it second and 13 now that's four catches today for Amari Airy. And it snapped, handed off to Felder. And that's going to be a gain of four. It looks like there might be a flag. See what the official call is. Okay, so it looks like that was going to be offsides on Charleston. So second and seven coming up. Jantois is going to roll out, and he throws it to Johnson on the out route. It's incomplete. So now third down, seven to go. I'm surprised that the Yellow Jackets haven't given it to Felder a whole lot this half. I mean, I know he's carried it 15 times a lot tonight, but that's the guy that's been your playmaker, especially even more so tonight needed, as it's third and seven, and they need to get past their own 37 to get the first down to the Yellow Jackets. Jantois drops back. He's going to run, and he's brought down. Ball comes out. And it's recovered. And Charleston is going to score on the defensive end. Touchdown, Golden Eagles. Scoop and score on that play, and so they were able to get the ball out and get into the end zone on that. So Charleston gets another one up on the board, and now the touchdown on that play, and so that looked like it was. I'm gonna make sure because the angle I'm at, but that looked like it was Andrew Chambly, and it was Andrew Chambly. We had the official call on it, so congratulations to Chambly on the big play. You don't see defensive players score often, and Chambly able to live that one up and get into the end zone. So Charleston now with the extra point, and that one is good as they've scored 35 in a row here, and now it's a 35-7 ball game. So here we go, 2:27 to go in the third, and West Virginia State will get the ball back shortly. We'll be right back. You're watching Yellow Jacket Football on the MEC Network, brought to you by Video Productions.
Life, things aren't scripted.
If you're an athlete, we need people like you and translate those skills to officiate.
You can get a lot out of it.
It happens in every town, in every game.
We never have a perfect game, but the rewards always outweigh the negativities.
Chambly for the Golden Eagles scores on a scoop and score defensively. However, the replay official looked at it, and he actually, I'm not so sure Jantois was down, or it looked like he was possibly down on that. But either way, a touchdown for the Golden Eagles as Nolan Johnson takes it. And we have some extracurricular activity on the field. Flags flying. And it's starting to get a little bit ugly now. It was the two teams, a lot of taunting going on before the game between the two. And these two teams, they do not like each other. And I think now with the score of what it is, we may see some of this stuff start to manifest itself. And hopefully we'll see cooler heads prevail on both sides. flags down, I'm expecting we'll probably see an unsportsmanlike called both ways that will offset. Yeah. Although looking back at it, we'll see, it looks like there was a punch thrown. Okay, so it does not look like there will be an ejection. I thought for a second that we were going to have an ejection, so it's going to be 1st and 10 coming up on the 14-yard line for West Virginia State. And it snapped. Jantois is going to hand it off. And Felder, left side, he's drugged down. That was Rashad Morris got loose on the outside. Morris, again, a good job getting the legs and making the tackle. And now that's going to make it 2nd and 15 coming up. Jantois, it's going to be a quick out thrown to Airy, but just a little bit over his head. That's going to make it 3rd down now and 14 coming up. So now the Yellow Jackets will need to get past their own 24 for the 1st down. And that's the thing. The Yellow Jackets are 5 of 13 on 3rd down, and looks like we have movement, but I don't think they've been about 5 or 6 straight where they haven't had a 3rd down conversion, and that's going to be false start on the Yellow Jackets. That'll be their 5th penalty of the game. So 5 penalties for 49 yards for the Yellow Jackets and 5 for 55 for the Golden Eagles at this point here, as it's going to be Jantois and Felder in the backfield. And it's going to be handed off to Felder and started to get a train of steam but drugged down. Gallagher hung on to him and was able to pull him down before he could get any big gain. So now it's going to be 4th and 15 coming up for the Yellow Jackets. Schmidt back to punt, and he's going to take it, and it's kicked. It's going to go back and caught. And they're going to run this one back, and he gets out of bounds. Now Marrero with the return, and that'll make it a 1st down coming up for the Golden Eagles here, who are up quite comfortably late in the 3rd quarter after that defensive touchdown by Chambly. Although I don't know, looking back, I'm going to look back at that again, but looking back, I really don't know if he was down on that. I have to take a closer, maybe a couple more looks at that. See, interesting call, though, but that's going to make it 1st and 10 now coming up. And it's snapped and handed off. They're going to give it to Wright up the middle, and he's going to push the pile and push it past the 1st down marker. I apologize, that was Brink. Brink, who has over 500 yards rushing on the season, gets the 1st down. And that'll be the second double-digit run that he's had tonight. So first and 10 coming up for the Golden Eagles. And it's handed off again. Brink's going to gain 6. Tristan Thompson and Avery Scott on the tackle, so 2nd and 4. So they're going to let this one run out. So at the end of 3, the Golden Eagles lead the Yellow Jackets 35-7 here at Dickerson Stadium, Lake and Ray Field. We're going to take a break and come back. You're watching Yellow Jacket Football on the MEC Network, brought to you by Video Productions.
In NCAA Division II, community engagement is an initiative at all 25 national championships because student-athletes want to give back while competing for a national title. Over the course of the year, Division II student-athletes have an opportunity to leave a lasting impression in local communities throughout the country. Whether Division II student-athletes are volunteering at hospitals, schools, after-school care programs, foster homes, or retirement villages, they make a difference in the lives of others. In Division II, we rise to the opportunity and make community engagement ours.
Choosing health coverage for your family, your employees, and your company is one of the most important decisions you can make. The health plan proudly supports our active and healthy communities and has been your most trusted carrier for over 40 years. We are here for your family. We are here for your business. We'll be here for you when you need us most, because your health coverage is our priority. The health plan, here for you.
And we're back here. So 2nd and 3 coming up for the Golden Eagles. I imagine we'll see them try to utilize clock control in this quarter, as Brink's going to get some more tough yards up the middle and a first down. So now 1st and 10. And it's handed off. Brink again carrying defenders up the middle. The big guy's going to get 8. So 2nd down and 3 coming up. That was Lomax on the tackle, his 4th tonight. And it snapped, handed off up the middle again. Wright is going to power his way and get about 7. So now, and this is the result of the West Virginia State defense being on the field much of this second half, and it's just worn them down, as they're going to be, it's going to be 1st and 10 now as they get closer, and they are in again in the red zone. And it's going to be a pass this time, fade to the end zone, and caught but deflected out of bounds. That was good defense by number 5, Justin David, the senior. Able to knock the ball out. And Howard does a good job placing those fade routes, as he's 17-25 tonight, 203 yards and 3 scores. So now it'll be 2nd and 10 coming up. And it snapped, handed off, and carried and a whole host of Yellow Jackets there to make the defensive stop. That was Jai Martin leading the way. That was number two, Josh Brown, the senior from Knoxville, Tennessee, that carried the ball. So now third and 11 coming up. And it snapped and thrown out to Brown and complete. So that's going to make it fourth down now, as the field goal unit gets ready to come on for Charleston. So that's going to be McCutcheon, the senior, out to for the attempt. Snap is up, kicks up, and it looks good. That it sure is. So now McCutcheon gets the field goal, and Charleston takes a 38-7 lead here in the fourth. So we'll be right back. You're watching the Yellow Jacket football here on the MEC Network, brought to you by Video Productions.
Life, things aren't scripted.
If you're an athlete, we need people like you and translate those skills to officiating.
You can get a lot out of it.
It happens in every town, in every game.
We never have a perfect game, but the rewards always outweigh the negativities.
Back, Tim McCutcheon, the senior from Hurricane, West Virginia, hits his eighth field goal of the season. He's 8 of 14, and also the 38th field goal of his career. The senior from Hurricane, West Virginia, as now this is going to be kicked off once again. I imagine we'll see Paxton back there again for the Golden Eagles, who are fresh on their way to winning the MEC championship, leading by 31 here in the fourth quarter, as that'll be Pessoa back to return. Pessoa, the sophomore running back from Dayton, New Jersey, played for Dayton High School. It's kicked off, and it's going to go back. Pessoa will field that one, and he's going to break through one defender, try to cut back to the middle, but unable to get anywhere, as that's going to be first and 10 starting from the 12-yard line, the Yellow Jackets. So now that's at the top of your screen. That's Nolan Johnson and Jawan Bunch at receiver. At the bottom, that's Tayshawn Butler and Amari Airy with backfield. That's handed off to Felder, left side. He's looking for room. Felder, he's going to stay on his feet and get a first down. Felder, depending on the spot, he's real close to 100 yards. He had 87 coming into this drive. The 354 yards of offense for Yellow Jackets, and it's going to be picked off. And that is going to be another defensive touchdown for the Golden Eagles. That is number 25, Roderick Webb, the 175-pound sophomore, coming in and making the score. And flags fly. Webb getting in the crowd and soaking in the moment, celebrating his score, and that'll be unsportsmanlike, the penalty against Charleston. So that penalty will be enforced on the kickoff. So two defensive touchdowns today for the University of Charleston. So McCutcheon on to attempt the extra point. It snaps, and it looks good. It is good. So McCutcheon now, he's hit his 50th extra point of the season here in this one. And we are going to take a break and come back. You're watching Yellow Jacket Football on the MEC Network, brought to you by Video Productions.
In NCAA Division II, community engagement is an initiative at all 25 national championships because student-athletes want to give back while competing for a national title. Over the course of the year, Division II student-athletes have an opportunity to leave a lasting impression in local communities throughout the country. Whether Division II student-athletes are volunteering at hospitals, schools, after-school care programs, foster homes, or retirement villages, they make a difference in the lives of others. In Division II, we rise to the opportunity and make community engagement ours.
Choosing health coverage for your family, your employees, and your company is one of the most important decisions you can make. The Health Plan proudly supports our active and healthy communities and has been your most trusted carrier for over 40 years. We are here for your family. We are here for your business. We'll be here for you when you need us most, because your health coverage is our priority. The Health Plan, here for you.
And we're back. So the Charleston fans already unveiling the Mountain East Conference Championship banner. So I know they got a big lead in this one. I'd be a little leery until that clock hit zero. So now this is going to be kicking, so they will be kicking from the 20 after the unsportsmanlike penalties. Will Paxton. A score, though, an interception return by number 25, Roderick Webb. And it's kicked back. That'll be Felder returning it. Felder, 30, 35, 40, 45, and he powers his way, still on his feet, and he's going to get knocked back to the 45. So Schweinfuss and Austin on the tackle. So an offsides penalty against Charleston on the kickoff. West Virginia State has elected to take the penalty tacked on to the end of the run. So this will make it 1st and 10 coming up. Now for the Yellow Jackets, who start past midfield. And it's going to be handed off. Felder up the middle. And he's going to be met by Golden Eagles. So now that's going to make it second and about eight. Well, that was number 46, Schweinefuss, on the tackle. The junior from Hamilton, Ohio, has now second and eight. And Jantois going to drop back. He looks. He's going to run it and get pushed out of bounds after a gain. So that was Chambly who pushed him out of bounds. So that'll make it third and four now. There's a five-yard gain. It'll be more like third and three. And I imagine two down territory for the Yellow Jackets at this point. And it's Jantois, quick throw, caught by Airy. And he's going to get close to the 20-yard line of the Golden Eagles. So a gain of 18. That's Jantois' 12th pass completion tonight, as he goes over 100 yards through the air. And it's handed off to Felder up the middle, and he gets drugged down. That's a tough front four for Charleston. That was big number 98, Nathan Caldwell, the 6'3", 275-pound sophomore from Lynchburg, Virginia. As now Jones comes back in for the Yellow Jackets, as they're going to go shotgun trips, Airy isolated at the bottom of your screen, second and nine coming up. Snapped, Jantois throws it to Johnson, and he's going to stay on his feet but not get much of a gain, about four. It could have been a situation, honestly, as slow of a pass as that was getting there. Lucky that one wasn't intercepted, as that's going to be third and six now coming up for the Yellow Jackets. 6 of 15 on third down is the Yellow Jackets, as Jantois is going to go to the end zone. It's overthrown, but a flag down. That's likely going to be called pass interference. And that's going to be pass interference on the defense. So that will give a first down to the Yellow Jackets. That will be the eighth penalty against, or the eighth penalty going against Charleston. So now that'll make it first and goal from about the four. Man in motion, it's handed off to Felder, right side. He looks for room, gets into the end zone. Touchdown, Yellow Jackets. So the Yellow Jackets able to get on the board again as they score for the second time this game. They led 7-0 early. And, I mean, it was a close game for the first half, but the second half, Charleston able to pull away. So a personal foul on the after the play against Charleston, and that will result in it being enforced on the upcoming kickoff, which will put them past 100 yards in penalties. And that's going to be a two-point play coming up. And That's going to be stopped. Jantois brought down. So that's good. So right now, so Charleston leading 45-13 here in the fourth. We're going to take a break and come back. You're watching Yellow Jacket Football on the MEC Network, brought to you by Video Production.
Life, things aren't scripted.
If you're an athlete, we need people like you and translate those skills to officiating.
You can get a lot out of it.
It happens in every town, in every game.
We never have a perfect game, but the rewards always outweigh the negativities.
And we're back. It's 45-13 as West Virginia State scores on a four-yard run by Felder, who just picked up touchdown number 12 on the year, setting the all-time single-season record for a running back at West Virginia State. So now we'll see the kickoff. There's unsportsmanlike. It actually went against West Virginia State and not Charleston, as I initially implied. So it will, my mistake is that, so that will be enforced on the kickoff, and West Virginia State will be kicking from the 20-yard line. So the penalties right now, West Virginia State has 6 for 64, and Charleston has 8 for 90. Schmidt back to kick. And it's kicked way back. And here we go. As Charleston has it, a flag down, two flags down. We're on the return. We'll see what the penalties are. And that's going to be holding against Charleston. So we'll see where the spot of the foul is and where the officials decide to play. It looks like they're going to place it at the 39, so good starting field position coming up for the Golden Eagles. They're going to put it back at about the 29. So that'll make it first and 10. So shotgun formation, and I imagine we'll see plenty more running the football and clock control coming from the Golden Eagles as it's handed off Brown left side, and he's going to get two, maybe three. Right. Actually, a gain of about one, so that'll make it second and 9. And that was Nicholas Fannin on the tackle. 4 tackles for him tonight. The third carry for Brown. All Oh, here we go on this second down. And it snapped. It's handed off Brown. No, it's going to be a quarterback keeper. And he's brought down the right side. And a good read on that play. And honestly, just about the entire West Virginia State defense, with the exception of number 45, Tillman, the junior from Stone Mountain, Georgia, from Parkview High School, about everybody but him was faked out. He did a good job getting back there and making the disciplined tackle. So now 3rd and 8 here on this drive. And they will need to get to Fannin also in on that. And so they will need to get past their own 39 for the first down. It's going to be handed off up the middle again. Brown, a tank of steam, and he has plenty of room. Brown, 45, 40, 35, 30. And he gets brought down about the 20. Brown with a huge run up the middle on 3rd and long. As Charleston, only 3 of 9 tonight on 3rd down conversions, but Brown jets through there for 50. So that'll be a gain of 49 for Josh Brown. His 4th rush, he has 56 yards on the game. And so the numbers for Charleston, Wright with 99, Brink with 57, and Brown with 56 on the night. So the team over 200 yards on the ground. As Charleston, almost as many rushing yards, 202, as the Yellow Jackets have total. We're going to take a break and come back. You're watching the MEC Network, brought to you by Video Productions.
In NCAA Division II, community engagement is an initiative at all 25 national championships because student-athletes want to give back while competing for a national title. Over the course of the year, Division II student-athletes have an opportunity to leave a lasting impression in local communities throughout the country. Whether Division II student-athletes are volunteering at hospitals, schools, after-school care programs, foster homes, or retirement villages, they make a difference in the lives of others. In Division II, we rise to the opportunity and make community engagement ours.
Okay, we had an injury. Corlin Witcher went down, but good news in that he got up and was able to jog off the field on his own will and looks okay on the sidelines. So it's going to be 1st and 10 now coming up as a big 49-yard run by Josh Brown puts the Golden Eagles in the red zone once again. As they go in motion, it snapped, handed off to Brown again, and he's going to slither up there for 4 or 5 more. Still moving the pile a little bit. So they're going to call that a gain of about 5. That big gain also on the prior play also put Charleston past 400 yards of offense on the game. As now it's going to be 2nd and about 5. And it snapped and handed off again. Brown continuing to move his feet, and he's going to get a 1st down. Brown really hitting his stride on this drive. As now that's going to make it 1st and goal. So that'll be 1st and goal coming up from the 9 for the Golden Eagles. And handed off Brown this time, tripped up before he can get back to the line. And it looked like that was Vargas that got back there, the 6'195" linebacker from Toledo, Ohio, to make the stop. Or no, I apologize, that was Jai Martin. Martin from Clover, South Carolina, who made the play. So now second and goal from the 10. Josh Brown with 66 yards rushing on the night. And it snapped, handed off up the middle, and he's going to go up the middle and just couldn't quite get in there. That was Brink, I believe. So now that's going to be third and goal from the 1. And that's Alex Brink's 9th carry. He has 66 yards. So 3 players above 60 yards rushing for the Golden Eagles, as Wright's just a yard short of 100. And it snapped Brown right side, and he's going to get into the end zone for the touchdown. A touchdown Charleston, and they will go out for the extra point coming up. So now Paxton out to kick. And it kicks up, and it's good. So 3:38 remaining in this one. It's 52-13. Charleston leading West Virginia State. We're going to take a break and come back. You're watching Yellow Jacket Football on the MEC Network, brought to you by
Life, things aren't scripted.
If you're an athlete, we need people like you and translate those skills to officiating.
You can get a lot out of it.
It happens in every town, in every game.
We never have a perfect game, but the rewards always outweigh the negativities.
We're back, 3:38 remaining in this one. As it's kicked deep, Felder will return. And he's going to take it. He gets the 25 and trying to get the ball out. He gets close to the still staying in there. Apologizes. Now that's going to make it first and 10 coming up for the Yellow Jackets. Just a tough break for the Yellow Jackets this year. Had a great 4-1 start. Expectations were high. And just a couple injuries here and there. And just some luck that just didn't quite go their way. But a heck of a good senior group that came through that set a good leadership model. This is a program, again, that has come a long, long way from before. As it's handed off to Felder. And Swinefest making the stop. So that's going to be second and 10. And it's going to go, they're going to go Felder again, left side, and he's going to be tripped up for a gain of 2. Schweinfuss again on the tackle. So that'll make it third and 10 now. And the Yellow Jackets will need to get past their own 34 to get the first down. And it's faked. Jantois is going to throw it, and it's going to be a third, or no, well, close to a third defensive touchdown, as that one was picked off by number 37, Colton Goldie, the redshirt freshman from Logan, West Virginia, and that is going to set Charleston up first and goal. Thought for a second he had a wide open route to the end zone, but it looks like good hustle not giving up by State to get back there and prevent what would have been the third defensive touchdown for the Golden Eagles. Okay. Catch it also. Want to take the opportunity before I forget to say thank you to our production team. We have Robbie Mounts up here with me, as that's going to be a sideline warning against Charleston. Or no, that's going to be a 15-yard unsportsmanlike going against Charleston. I also want to thank Cade Burgess, who's on camera. And that's the one thing, if Charleston keeps – I mean, I know it's good to – you want to celebrate your scores, but that's happened a lot tonight. Over, I believe, 115 yards in penalty. Yeah, 10 penalties for 115 yards for Charleston. If they keep that up, I mean, that could hinder them coming up in the future. And they have a good team and the chance to do a lot of things. So they're going to have to really – work on cutting that back, as that is, I think that was Blake Thompson on the carry. That was Jeter on the stop, so that'll be second and, or that's going to be my apology, it's not going to be second, it's going to be second and 10, so they're starting at first and 10, so that was Blake Thompson's first carry. The freshman from Alpharetta, Georgia. And that'll go again, no gain. Jai Martin on the tackle. Also new quarterback, and it looks like that Ian Hamrick has checked in, the 6'1", 185 freshman from Glenville, West Virginia. Oh, now it's faked, and it's the ball stripped out of there. West Virginia State has it. And Martin lost it, but it's going to, the officials are pointing toward the Yellow Jackets. They tried to throw in deep, but looked like a, see the fake, and they got back there and forced the ball out. And that was number 39, Xavius Hager, the senior linebacker from Forest, Virginia, who made the recovery. So now with 40 seconds to go in this one, it'll be first and 10 Yellow Jackets. Felder in the backfield. And it's handed off. Felder spins up the middle. Felder, he's going to cut back to the right. Felder, 40, 30, 25, 20. Still won't go down and gets close to the 10-yard line. And congratulations to Felder, who on that run broke the single season rushing record at West Virginia State University. As they're going to hand it to Felder again, this time met by a host of linemen, and he's going to get forced out of bounds. So Felder with the 45-yard rush, he is up to 152 on the night. So that'll make it second and about 11 or 12 coming up. A shotgun formation, Felder and Baker in the backfield. And it's going to be thrown to the end zone. Incomplete. Dangerous throw into a huddle of Golden Eagle defenders. That was intended for Fred Quigley, the senior from Washington, D.C. A quick timeout for injury. We'll take a quick break and come back here shortly. One play left coming up. You're watching Video Productions.
In NCAA Division II, community engagement is an initiative at all 25 national championships because student-athletes want to give back while competing for a national title. Over the course of the year, Division II student-athletes have an opportunity to leave a lasting impression in local communities throughout the country. Whether Division II student-athletes are volunteering at hospitals, schools, after-school care programs, foster homes, or retirement villages, they make a difference in the lives of others. In Division II, we rise to the opportunity and make community engagement ours.
Choosing health coverage for your family, your employees, and your company is one of the most important decisions you can make. The Health Plan proudly supports our active and healthy communities and has been your most trusted carrier for...
Joel Felder tacking on to that total and 21 yards for him, and that will be a touchdown for West Virginia State here with 3 seconds remaining. And it snaps, Schmidt to kick. It's up, and it's good. So 3 seconds remaining in this one. We'll just keep it here as, I mean, West Virginia State, I mean, they came out, they gave a good effort today. It was just, you could really just see the, I mean, a quarterback the caliber of Riddick and what he's been able to do this season and throughout his career, just not having him down there today, I mean, I think would have made this, you know, a much closer game than what it was. Of course, Charleston came in and they did what they needed to do to win the championship. I mean, I'll admit, I got to say, kind of, I mean, you know, saying what we want about their sportsmanship, they did come in and do what they needed to do to win this year. So they should have more football coming up. And, of course, you'll want to check local media providers that to see what they have and see what will be available for them. But West Virginia State will finish out at 4-6 this year. So now as Schmidt goes in to kick off. Here Felder finishes the day with 165 yards and 2 touchdowns on the ground. Just looking and noting that and mention the records that he broke today. A single season rushing record, touchdown record. And of course, the first 1,000-yard rusher this school has had since 1988. And it's going to be a squib, and it's caught, And the knee will be taken. And we have a skirmish coming. Sure enough, quick to break it up. Be in there and break it up. So that'll be the final, 52-20. We're going to take a break and come back. You're watching the MEC Network. Okay, we're back. I thought initially we were going to go to break, but two teams coming out now and much calmer situation. I mean, a high school game I called the other week, one of the teams actually would not shake hands out of concern that, you know, it could trigger a suspension or whatnot for their next game. But of course, Charleston celebrating a big win today on the road against a rival, 52-20, as they're able to come in and pull off the big win. It was a close game in the first half as West Virginia State opened up with the first score, an 8-yard touchdown pass to Nate Baker. But Charleston would end up leading 14-7 at halftime and a 21-0 third quarter with their Mountain East Conference Championship. And a hard-fought conference it was this year. You had they actually suffered a loss earlier this season to Fairmont State. And, of course, West Virginia State finishing the year 4-6. I mean, but they'll be back. They have a lot of reasons to be optimistic. And, of course, Coach Pennington and the 7 seasons he's been there has turned this program from one that was really struggling to one that has come around and done some big things. I think we'll see some good things continued here in the future in this program. But first off, I want to say to thank you to all the fans for letting us come in and broadcast your games here with Video Productions. And of course, I want to say thank you to Robbie Mounts, who's up here with me in the press box handling production. And also thank you to Cade Burgess, who is on camera tonight. And thank you to Butch Mounts for organizing everything. And no doubt about it, I want to thank Brian Shepherd up here for all his help and preparation and this season, and to James Garcia as well. And to the program as a whole, just a lot of enthusiasm at West Virginia State and a lot of good reasons to continue the excitement. So we want to say thank you for watching here in this one. And I guess we'll go ahead and sign off for the season. So I'm Tyler Rowland. You've been watching Yellow Jacket Football here on the MEC Network, brought to you by Video Productions.